हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल हिंदी सीबीएसई क्लासरूम। प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू माय चैनल एंड हिट द बेल बटन नेक्स्ट टू इट सो दैट यू विल गेट नोटिफिकेशन व्हेनेवर आई पोस्ट अ न्यू वीडियो। आई हैव क्रिएटेड सेपरेट प्लेलिस्ट इन माय चैनल फॉर ईच एंड एवरी क्लास, सो प्लीज चेक द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स बिलो एंड सेलेक्ट अकॉर्डिंगली। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडेज टॉपिक। टुडेज टॉपिक इज क्लास 7 चैप्टर 11 रहीम के दोहे। ओके, सो लेट्स सी, फर्स्ट लेट अस रीड इट आउट। कही रहीम संपत्ति सगे बनत बहुत बहुरीत, विपत्ति कसौटी जे कसे तेई सांचे मीत। सो दिस दोहा इज अबाउट द फ्रेंडशिप, द फ्रेंडशिप विच इज रियल एंड विच इज फेक। सो हियर रहीम इज सेइंग when we have got wealth, we make a lot of friends by different ways, but when we have a problem at that time, who stands with us, that is the real friend. Okay, so now let's see the meaning word by word. Kahi, kahi means says. Rahim, Rahim, the poet of the doha. Rahim. Sampati means wealth. Sage means our people, that is the people who stand with us, that is our partners or friends or people. Banat, banat means made. Bahut, bahurit, bahut means many different ways. Reet means ways. Bipatti, bipatti means a problem. Kasoti means test. J means who. Kase means pass. So bipatti, kasoti, je kase, problem at that who passes the test when we have a problem. Tei sanche meet. Tei means they are, sanche means real or true, meet means friends. So says Rahim, sampati, wealth, people. Though kahit Rahim sampati sage. Says Rahim that when we have wealth, at that time the people who are standing with us, banat bahut bahirit, they are made by different ways. Bipatti kasoti je kase, at the problem at the time in our life when we have problem, who passes the test, that is who stands with us even at the time when we have a problem. Tei sanche meet, they are the real friends. Okay, so I hope you understood this doha. That is, Rahim says at the time of when we are rich or when we are wealthy, we will make many friends in different ways, but when we have a problem or when we are in a situation where we cannot come out of it, that time who is there with us, those are the people who have passed the test of friendship, and those are our real friends. Okay, so now let's move on to the second one. Jal pare jal jat bahi taji meenan ko moh, rahiman machri neer ko tau na chaadti chho. So this is about love. The first one was about friendship. This one is about true love. So here the Rahim is telling that when the fishing net is dropped and when it is pulled out, you would have seen only fishes will be there in the net. The water will leave. So when the fishing net is dropped and it's pulled out, the water does, it leaves the fish. And it flows back to where it belongs. It leaves the fish. That is, it leaves the affection, because the fish and the water was together all this time. But water leaves it when there is a problem or when the fish is being taken out. The water leaves it. But the fish never leaves or never loses the love towards the water. Because when the fish is taken out of the water, it dies. because the fish cannot live without water, but water still survives. And it never cares also that fish has been taken. It makes no difference to the water. So here the Rahim is talking about true love. If we love someone with our true heart, if they leave us, we will die. We will die means we will lose everything, even our life. But the people who just love us fake, who just don't love us in real, they will leave us and they live their life as nothing happened. So this is about the true love. So let's see the word by word meaning. Jal. Jal means fishing net. Pare. Pare means dropped. Jal. Jat bahi. Jal means water. Jat bahi means it keeps on flowing. Bahi means flowing. Taji meenan ko moh. Taji means it leaves. Leaves. Meenan ko moh. Meenan means fish. Moh means love. When? So, jal pare jal jat bahi. When the fishing net is dropped, at that time, the water flows away. Taji meenan ka moh. Leaving the love and care that it had towards the fish. As soon as the fishing net is dropped, it leaves the affection or love towards the fish and it flows. Rahiman machri neer ko. Rahim says, but the fish, neer ko. Neer means, Rahiman means, Rahim says, machri means fish. Neer means water. But the fish never leaves the water. Tau na chhodti choh. Tau, then too. Na, na means never, no. Chhodti, chhadti means leaves. Choh, choh means love. Machri neer ko tau na chhodti chah. Then also, fish never leaves the love and affection it had towards the water. So, this doha is about true love. When the fishing net is dropped and when it is pulled out, you can see the water flows out without caring. It leaves the love towards the fish at that spot and it moves on. As if nothing happened. But the fish never leaves or never forgets the love it had towards the water and it dies. So, the meaning of this doha is that when we love someone with our true heart, when our love is true, what happens? When they leave us, it hurts us and we die eventually. That is, we die in our heart and we cannot survive with it. That someone we had loved truly, it leaves us, we cannot survive with it. But if our love is not true, then even if they leave us, it won't bother us. Okay, and we will leave and we will move on as if nothing happened, just like water. So water's love towards the fish is not true, but the love of fish towards water is true. So that's all about this doha. I hope you understood. So now let's move on to the next one. Taruvar fal nahi khat hai. Sarvar piyat na paan. Kahi Rahim par kaj hit. Sampati sachahi sujan. So here they are talking about doing work for other people or like charity or like... Parupkar. Parupkar means doing something that is good for others and we don't get back in return anything. So that is the meaning of Parupkar. Okay. So here the poet is telling, as trees don't eat their own fruits and lake doesn't drink its own water, in the same way good people or nice-hearted people spends all their wealth for the needies or for other people's welfare or account for their need. Okay. Trees also make fruits, but they don't eat themselves. They provide for the world, for the birds, for the humans, for everyone around them. They never consume it. Same way, the lake also, what it does, it gives water to us, for the animals, for the birds. They never take it back. They never drink it on their own. So they are doing it for others. They are making water for the others. The trees are making fruits for others. The same way, the sajjan, that is a gentleman or nice person or nicely hearted persons, make wealth in order to serve the needy people, in order to spend their wealth for the welfare of other people. Okay, so that is the meaning. So now let's see word to word. Taruvar. Taruvar means trees. Phal, fruits. Nahi, don't. Khat, eat. Trees don't eat their own fruits. Sarovar. Sarovar means lake. Piyat, drinks. Na, don't. Pan, water. Lake don't drink its own water. Kahi, Rahim, Parkajhit. Kahi says, Rahim. Parkaj means, that is par means others. Kaj means work. So the work done for others. Hit means welfare for them. Kahi Rahim Parkajhit says Rahim that for others welfare. Sampati Sanchahi Sujan. Sampati Sachahi. Sampati means wealth. Sachahi means they collect or they spend. They spend Sujan. Sujan means gentleman or nice hearted person. So Kahi Rahim Parkajhit says Rahim that for others welfare. Sampati Sachahi Sujan. Sampati, that is wealth. They use their wealth or they spend their wealth for others welfare. Okay, trees don't drink their own, trees don't eat their own fruits. Lake don't drink its own water. In the same way, says Rahim that a nice hearted person will never consume their own wealth. They will make or they will spend their money for the welfare of others, keeping in mind that they won't get anything in return. But still, they believe in doing something for the others. So, first doha was about friendship. Second doha is about true love. Third is about doing something for the others. Okay? So, now let's move on to the fourth one. Tote badal kwarke jo rahim gharat. धनी पुरुष निर्धन भये करे पाचली बात. सो हियर दे आर टॉकिंग सॉरी द पोएट इज टॉकिंग अबाउट वी शुड नॉट स्टिक इन अवर पास्ट वी शुड सी अबाउट अवर फ्यूचर. सो हाउ ही इज एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट ही इज टेलिंग एज द क्लाउड्स इन द ऑटम सीजन जस्ट मेक थंडर साउंड विदाउट एनी रेन. सो at that time the clouds are useless in the autumn season. The clouds are useless because they never rain in autumn season. So that's why the clouds are useless. They just make thundering sound which is disturbing and which is of no use. In the same way, when rich people become poor with some circumstances, they become poor and they don't have that much wealth they had before, they keep on saying how they lived in their past. They keep on repeating, I was like a princess in my past. I had these many things. I had these many that and all, etc., etc. But they never see how they can survive in this situation and how they can make their present condition better. But they keep on saying how they lived in their past, which is useless. Just like a cloud which makes thundering sound in the autumn season, which is useless. Okay, so let's see meaning word by word. Thote means useless. Badar means badal, that is cloud. Kuar means autumn season. K means clouds off. Thote badar kuar ke, useless clouds in the off autumn season. Jo rahim gharat, who only make thundering sounds. Says Rahim. Dhani Purush Nirdhan Bhaye. रिच धनी मीन्स रिच, पुरुष मीन्स मेन, निर्धन मीन्स पुअर, भये दे बिकम, करे करे मीन्स दे डू, पाचली बात, पाचली मीन्स पास्ट, ओल्ड और पास्ट, बात बात मीन्स बात मीन्स बात ओनली. सो वॉट दे डू, धनी पुरुष निर्धन भये, वेन अ रिच मैन बिकम्स पुअर, करे पाचली बात, दे टॉक, बात मीन्स टॉक, दे टॉक ओनली अबाउट देर पास्ट विच इज यूजलेस. सो वॉट ही इज टेलिंग, थोते बादर क्वार के यूजलेस क्लाउड ऑफ ऑटम सीजन, दे ओनली मेक थंडरिंग साउंड विच इज यूजलेस बिकॉज क्लाउड्स आर मेड फॉर रेनिंग एंड दे आर यूजलेस because they are making only thunder sound. In the same way, when a rich man or rich people become poor due to some circumstances, they only talk about their past, how they lived in their past. They never see how they can survive or how they can overcome their poverty and they can become or they can meet all their expectation, but they keep on clinging on their past that we were like this, we were like that, which is useless, which is of no use because it's over, it's done, now they are poor. So they have to live in the present rather than thinking about the past. It happens in all the way, not rich, even when we were very happy and now we are sad, we'll say, oh, I was very happy at that time, I was very happy at that time, but we never think that we can be happy at this present time if we change the circumstances or we work on it. So that is the meaning of this doha. So the last one is, dharti kisi reet hai seet gham o meh, jaisi pare so sahi rahe tyo rahim yah deh. So here the poet is telling, dharti kisi reet hai, the earth has a rule, seet gham aur meh, whatever the season may be, winter, summer or meh, meh means cloudy season, that is rainy season, jaisi pare so sahi rahe, whatever the season is, it will bear or it will tolerate, tyo rahim yah de, so rahim is telling, so should be our body. That is, so should be we ourselves also. So he is telling, the earth has a rule that it accepts whatever the season may be, or it tolerates whatever the season is running, that is winter, summer or rainy season. It never complains. It accepts whatever the phase it is going through. That is winter also, the earth is fine. Summer also it is fine. It accepts or it tolerates or it survives all the seasons without any problem. The same should happen to us also, or to our body also. Whatever comes in our life, we should survive it. Maybe it's sad, or maybe it's some tragedy, or maybe even it's a happy moment. We should not like go beyond that. We should enjoy the moment and that's it. Okay, so for earth it is same. Whether it is winter or summer or rainy season, for it is same. It should be to us also, whether it is happy life, happy time for us or sad time for us, or some tragedy has happened in our life, we should keep everything in a moderate level. Okay, whether it is a happy moment or sad moment, it should be a moderate level and we should be able to survive that. Okay, so that is the meaning of doha. So let's see the word by word meaning. Dharti, earth, kisi, has, its, reet hai means its rule or its way, seet means winter, gham means summer, o means or, and meh means cloud, that is rainy season, jaisi pare, however it is, so sahi rahe, that is, sahi means it tolerates or it survives. Tyo Rahim, same is for, Rahim says, Deh means body. So earth has its own rule that whether it is winter, summer or rainy season, however it is, it tolerates it. Sahi means it tolerates it. Tyo Rahim yah Deh. So it's the same. It should be same for our body also, says Rahim. Okay. So now let's revise. We learned 5 rules. One was about friendship, the first one, that is we will have a lots and lots of friends when we are wealthy, but the friends who pass the test, when that is how they'll pass the test, they will stick to us even when we have a problem. So they are our real friends. Second one is about true love, that is a fish could never leave the water because it loved the water truly, and when the water leaves it, it dies. But the water's love towards the fish was not true. That's why when the fish left us, or when the fish was in problem, the water left us without any care and it just flowed away as if nothing happened. So it's about true love. If we love someone with a true heart, it will affect us and we will die from our heart if that someone leaves us. But if our love is fake, if they leave us, it will not bother us and we will live our life as nothing happened. Third one is we should live, or we should at least do something for other people. That is because trees don't eat their own fruits, a lake does not drink their own water. In the same way, a wealthy a person with a nice heart should spend and should attain wealth in order to do welfare for others and in order to help needy people. And the fourth one is as a cloud just thunders out, just makes thundering sound or brings lightning in the autumn season is useless because it never rains in the autumn season. So in the same way, people who become poor from rich background, they should not keep on repeating how they lived in the past, and they should leave the past behind and they should concentrate on the present and how they can make their present better. Last one is, Earth has a rule that whether it is summer, winter or rainy season, the Earth tolerates it. The Earth survives every season. In the same way should be our body or mind should tolerate everything that comes in, that hits our life. Whether it is happiness or whether it is some tragedy, we should survive it and we should tolerate it and we should move on as if nothing happened. And we should keep on living our life with full happiness. So that's all. I hope you understood the Doha. Please let me know in the comment section below. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.